57 degrees, 56 degrees. I had to wear an overcoat, which I just love. I love the fog. But earlier in the day, it was sunny, not hot, down near the Embarcadero, near the ferry terminal. They have various people selling trinkets and whatnot, open-air market. And one of them is a caricaturist. The $3.99 will do you a one-minute portrait. You know the kind that do a sketch of you like a fisherman's wharf or you know where you are. So I watched this guy do it. He was very fast and very good. And for the first time in my life, I don't know what it was, I was tempted to spend the 10 bucks and say, do me a quick portrait. I don't know what it was. I didn't do it. But I wake up this morning and there's a quick portrait of me with a mouth I'm not sure about. So when I come back on the Savage Nation, I'm going to play a piece for you from the New Yorker, from the podcast of the article, right here on the Savage Nation. Later on, we'll do politics. Should I start reading the article? Wait a minute. Hold it. I'll read you a few sentences because many of you don't know what I'm talking about. Let's see. Even in this world of born-again refuseniks, Michael Savage is an anomaly. A heretic among heretics. Nearly as contemptuous of his fellow radio stars, he refers to Limbaugh as the golfer and calls Beck the hemorrhoid with eyes, as he is at President Obama. He calls himself a genuine independent conservative, which is a kind of sales pitch and apparently an effective one. His daily broadcast, The Savage Nation, is one of the most popular shows in the country. Then they go on, blah, 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 blah. I'm going to skip around here because some of this stuff made me laugh hysterically. The stuff about the dog is just funny, about me wanting to cook Teddy's leg. Not that I want to cook Teddy's leg. Like if I was starving to death and we're both going to die, sort of like a Sophie's Choice thing, would you cook your dog's leg since you're both going to die anyway? I'll be right back.
Don't make a difficult time tougher. If your inheritance is stuck in probate, we can advance you the cash you need in as little as 72 hours. Visit inheritancefunding.com or call 877-U-AIR. That's 877-Y-O-U-H-E-I-R.
These guys are so hilarious. I almost drive off the road every morning.
Armstrong and Getty. Weekday morning, 6 to 10. Talk 910 KNEW.
Take you back to another time in America. Let us say when John F. Kennedy was president, when a Democrat was more conservative than today's Republicans. You understand what I just said to you? Do you realize, and I've said this for over 10 years now, that by today's standards, the Republican Party has moved so far to the left and so lost its bearings that John F. Kennedy, by today's standards, would be a conservative compared to the Republicans of today. And of course, the Democrats today are the communists or the neo-Marxists. They don't even understand where they are, nor do they care. They don't care where they are politically. They do not care at all. Neither do I at this point. They're sinking as fast as the 51st Ward can sink. The American people, it's sinking into the American people that Obama is basically a front man for the Daily Machine and that they're treating the White House as though it's the 51st Ward of Chicago. In other words, it's entered their mind already. So here we are. Now, I'm telling you, I'm taking you back in time. So I'm reading biographies. Hemingway is one of my heroes, et cetera, and so on. And I, you know, read the New Yorker. There were other magazines that were out that I was reading. I forget them, but I'm running so short of time I could scream. First of all, I have a migraine today from the weekend. That's to start with. I ate too much radicchio last night, which is so acidic. I'll never eat it again. Can they serve me lettuce? Why do I have to eat? Everything's a trick. When I grew up, there was vinegar. Now everything's a trick vinegar. $5,000 a bottle, like wine now. Why does everything have to be special? You ask for a cup of coffee, you got coffee in my day. Now it's 50 different varieties. The same garbage with different prices. Mochiata, macchiata, lacamata, lacawana, choo-choo. What do I have to eat radicchio for? I have a migraine from the acid. So I'm in a bad mood to begin with. I'm going to play for you a piece of the interview on the podcast of the author of the article, Party of One, Profile of Michael Savage. Profile of Michael Savage by Mr. Senna, right now from the New Yorker on the Savage Nation. Fire
Michael
away.
Savage is one of the most popular conservative talk radio hosts in the country. His show, The Savage Nation, reaches more than 8 million listeners each week.
We so-called conservatives are actually the liberals of America. And the so-called liberals are the actual fascists of America.
Savage's disdain for the left is savage. One of his many books is called Liberalism is a Mental Disorder. But listeners to his show get a lot more than politics, as Kelly Fasano tells us in his profile this week. Welcome back, Kay.
Thanks.
So the election of Barack Obama has put conservatives back in the opposition, and that has re-energized talk radio. Is that what got you interested in doing this piece? And why did you pick Michael Savage, of all the conservative talk show hosts?
That's part of what got me interested in doing this piece. I'd heard him over the years and found myself listening to him a bunch last year during the election. And he was interesting partly because he seemed to be so off-message.
Oh, I know what you're expecting, but you're not going to get it from me. You'll have to go to one of the other talk show hosts to get Obama's a Marxist and McCain is a war hero. If that's what you want from now until November, you're in the wrong dial position.
Savage, despite being identified as a conservative talk show host, didn't really seem to like McCain that much.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely hated Obama. Didn't really like Bush.
So he was reacting really differently than the other conservative hosts.
Well, you know, most of the other conservative hosts, no matter what the problems they might have had with McCain, mm-hmm. were, they certainly supported him.
Right.
And Savage really didn't. But Savage has always been a really kind of unusual, weird guy. His mm-hmm. radio show isn't like anyone else's radio show.
Right. So he talks a lot less about politics than a lot of other talk show hosts.
Well, he's a lot less single-minded. He has this weird cluster of interests. He's mm-hmm. interested in herbal medicine. Mm-hmm. He's interested in animals. He loves food. He loves to tell stories about, you know, New York in the 50s and 60s. And he loves to talk about his life in a really unusual way. He has this kind of melancholy, depressive streak. And,
mm-hmm.
and so the takeaway isn't necessarily, you know, we're going to rally the troops and we're going to get this done politically. The takeaway is often, I'm probably going to go home and drink tonight. And that makes him a really interesting, really compelling character.
When the New Yorker comes up on a show like Savage's or Rush's, it's generally not in glowing terms. Michael Savage is, my guess, not a longtime subscriber to the magazine.
Well, he is a longtime reader.
He is.
Yeah, yeah, okay. He grew up in New York, and he has said he did grow up reading.
This is the Savage Nation on Talk 910 KNEW.
Savage Nation. It's an unusual show today. I'm not doing much politics. I'll do that maybe later. I'll do it tomorrow. We're talking instead about a profile of Michael Savage entitled Party of One by Kalefa Sena. It's a major league profile in league with people I've respected in my life, such as Fellini, Gandhi, Albert Einstein, Dizzy Gillespie, Martin Scorsese. I know you say, what, are you crazy? No, maybe you're crazy. Maybe you're crazy for not understanding who you've been listening to all these years. And so, therefore, I'm going to talk about the profile because it's going to lead me to the next thing I'm going to do in my life, which is the movie. Now I'm pretty sure I'm going to do the documentary called The Savage Nation of my life story tied into the politics. But in a way, it may be based a little bit upon this. And that's why it's important you listen to it. To understand that although I'm a independent conservative politically, that's not really what the show is about necessarily. That's a hard part of what it's about, sure. But you can hear that everywhere. Today, you got a lot of conservatives in the media, right? What you get from me is a lot more and a lot different. The melancholy, depressive streak that the author mentions appealed to me. It made me laugh. Why did that make me laugh when he said, there's not, he's not like the others, there's a melancholy, depressive streak in him? Why did I laugh when I heard that? I don't know why, because I have a weird sense of humor. He also said Michael Savage is weird. I like that. It made me happy. You understand this? Do you get an idea what I'm talking about? We now go back to the podcast. Is that what they call it these days? Is it podcast? Podcast. There's something about the word pod that I don't like. It reminds me of all the science fiction movies, you know, where the pod people are coming. We now go back to the podcast of the author of the article, Party of One, about Michael Savage, unexpurgated by Kalefa Sena. Listen.
Savage, despite being identified as a conservative talk show host, didn't really seem to like McCain that much.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely hated Obama. Didn't really like Bush.
So he was reacting really differently than the other conservative hosts.
Well, you know, most of the other conservative hosts, no matter what the problems they might have had with McCain, mm-hmm. were, they certainly supported him.
Right.
And Savage really didn't. But Savage has always been a really kind of unusual, weird guy. His radio show isn't like anyone else's radio show.
Right. So he talks a lot less about politics than a lot of other talk show hosts.
Well, he's a lot less single-minded. He has this weird cluster of interests. He's interested in herbal medicine. Mm-hmm. He's interested in animals. He loves food. He loves to tell stories about, you know, New York in the 50s and 60s. And he loves to talk about his life in a really unusual way. He has this kind of melancholy, depressive streak. And so the takeaway isn't necessarily, you know, we're going to rally the troops and we're going to get this done politically. The takeaway is often, I'm probably going to go home and drink tonight, and that makes him a really interesting, really compelling character on the radio.
When the New Yorker comes up on a show like Savage's or Rush's, it's generally not in glowing terms. Yeah. Michael Savage is, my guess, not a longtime subscriber to the magazine.
Well, he is a longtime reader.
He is.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
He grew up in New York, and he has said he did grow up reading it.
So, how hard was it to get him to talk to you, and how did you go about that?
Well, basically, I sent a bunch of emails to his people and finally got an email.